What is viewport?
This term is an SVG, but there is no SVG attribute and properties with this name. By this term, we mean two attributes, width and height. We determine the dimensions of the rectangle in which SVG graphics will appear. Initial viewport, width 300 pixels and height 150 pixels. This is a very large rectangle, but its default viewport. We increase the viewport. What is viewbox? This is an SVG attribute with settings for the image. The first two parameters, X and Y, are responsible for panning. The second two are width and height for scaling. This is the end of the preview. Let's move on to the study of the fifth chapter of the SVG fundamental.
At the previous chapters, we have accepted the fact that the height and the width of the SVG element were set to 100% of the user agent viewport. I have made this for a certain purpose. I could draw the graphic elements directly in the browser window, but the cases when the SVG element occupies the entire viewport of the device is very rare. Usually, you will use the SVG fragments that will be embedded inside the HTML document. In this chapter, we will examine a topic that is very difficult to explain. Usually the authors avoid its explanation. They show a very simple way that helps to avoid the problem with misunderstanding of the subject, but this way doesn't lead to a complete understanding. I want you to know why these problems may arise and how they can be corrected. After this chapter, you will understand how simple the subject is. In the previous chapters, we added the graphic elements into the SVG element by placing them into the local coordinate system that started in the upper left corner and ended in the lower right corner. I can honestly admit that I was cheating. This was done consciously. I didn't want to confuse you from the very beginning. And now the time has come, and I will explain how the SVG actually works. Each time you insert the SVG element into the HTML or XML document, the SVG element creates two initial coordinate systems. The first coordinate system is the initial coordinate system of the viewport, which can be anywhere in a document, and whose size depends on the height and the width attributes. I call it the visible coordinate system layer, which, to be honest, hasn't any graphics. And now, I assume you have a question. Are you saying that the viewport doesn't contain any graphics? Then where is the graphics? As I said, the SVG element creates two coordinate systems. The second coordinate system is the initial local coordinate system, which by default starts at the same point as the viewport coordinate system. But unlike the viewport coordinate system, this coordinate system is infinite. The local coordinate system is the place where the graphics lives. How does the local coordinate system work? You will learn in the next lesson. In this lesson, we will explore the relationship between the viewport, the viewbox, and the local coordinate system. And that's all for now. Do your homework, and I will see you in the next lesson.